Should be nothing less than 40,000 euros. When I saw this, I'm like, ooh, it's a lot. No. Hey guys, what's up and welcome back to my channel. My name is Bolu Tife, but of course you can call me Tife. So today I'm here to talk about something that I've been getting a lot of DMs about, a lot of messages, and even like on my YouTube comment and everything. So the reason why I really not wanted to talk about this, by the way, I'm talking about health insurance for students, international students coming from other countries to Finland. So the reason why I didn't want to talk about this at first is that it's been long I did mine, which was 4 years ago, and I didn't want to give out the wrong information. But anyways, I took it upon myself to go research some things and come here to tell you guys about it. So before we actually get straight into the video, be sure to like this video, be sure to subscribe, and be sure to share the video and turn on your post notifications so you're notified whenever I post a new video. So having said all that, let's get straight into the video. So what is health insurance? Health insurance is just I'm sure you all know. Anyways, health insurance is just like you being able to afford your health expenses when you come to Finland, be it drugs or being sick. And they are just trying to make sure, when I say they, I mean the Finnish immigration are just trying to make sure that you are that you can afford all this, and it's not on them, because if you can't afford it, then it has to be on them. You know what I'm talking about. So that's to clarify why exactly you have to have the health insurance. So they have some requirement about the health insurance. Don't worry, I will link all this down below in from where I got them from, so you see for yourself and you actually follow the steps for yourself. So one of the first requirement for the insurance is that the excess must not be more than 300 euros. So first of all, when I said that, I was like, what is excess, what is excess, what is excess? Anyway, so I found out that excess is the amount that you pay to make a claim. So apparently, before you make a claim, you have to pay a particular amount of money. So they are just trying to say that the excess shouldn't be more than 300 euro. And of course, be sure to convert this money to naira or to any other currency that you're using. So convert this money to your currency to be able to fathom, or to be able to understand what they are talking about in your currency. So I'm just gonna leave it at that. So that's one of their first requirements. So their second requirement is that the insurance must be valid for at least a year. Wait, if you're coming to study in Finland for less than a year, let's say exchange student, or say double degree student or something like that, your insurance should be valid for a year. Was it a year? Was it valid for a year? Of course, so your insurance must be valid for a year. But if you are coming here to study as a degree student, masters or anything whereby your study is more than 2 years, so your insurance does not have to be that old, 2 years, but it has to be valid for at least 1 year. So then you are able to like renew it after 1 year. So apparently what you're just trying to say is that if you are here to study as a degree student longer, your insurance does not have to be that particular amount of year. It can be 1 year and then you renew it, so and so like that. I have a hint for you guys, or like a tip, which I will say after all this, but let's just continue our point. Another of their requirement is that the insurance period must be valid on your date of arrival in Finland. Like, you cannot come to Finland in May and then the insurance starts in October. It doesn't work like that. It has to be valid from that May or even before. But I will advise that May, even if it's that day, so that you know you use it for as long as possible. So as far as it's valid on the period in on your arrival period in Finland. So be sure about that. Be sure and be meticulous when choosing your date and you know all those stuff. So another of their requirements is that if you are studying for at least 2 years, that's like degree students, your pharmaceutical expense should be nothing less than 40,000 euros. When I saw this, I'm like, ooh, it's a lot. No wonder like I've been getting DMs like, it's a lot, are we sure this is the right price? This is the right price. I don't know, I wish I can talk to them, like this is so unnecessary. But anyways, that is their requirement, and if you want to come to their country, you have to follow that requirement and at least provide what they are asking for. So it's 40,000 for for those that are coming here to study degree, you guys should not even be angry at all, because for exchange students or people that are coming here to study for like a year and less than 1 year, theirs is like 200 euros. I'm like, I'm sorry, what? So like, the shorter your study, the more your insurance value should be. So it was more like, I don't understand, but anyways, that's the point and that's their requirement. Nothing to do about it. So another important requirement of theirs is that on your insurance, you should have your name, you should have your details, the validity period and all those stuff. Just be sure that they are on the insurance whereby they can clearly see these things and there's no confusion. So the most important question of where to get the insurance from. So you can get your insurance from your own country, but also they have a list of recommended insurance companies. When I checked them, one was in France, some in Finland and all. In the link that I'm gonna link down below, you can find all those lists down there. So for me personally, when I was coming 4 years ago, I'm saying this 4 years ago, so you understand the fact that the information might have been expired or like they don't accept it anymore. So when I was coming here 4 years ago, I used either AICO or Mutual Benefit. I can't really remember. So you can check out those two, research about them before actually using them. Do you understand what I'm saying? So the tip that I was talking about, so the tip is that after you come here to study or to work in Finland, say you have 1 year insurance certificate, you can apply for this Kela card. So what is Kela? Kela is like this social assistant or social institution. They help with benefit anyways. They help with like student benefit or housing benefit or like just basic thing. Like if you can't afford, say, your rent this month, you apply to Kela, like, oh, so and so up, I can't afford my rent and everything. So they are those people, they help with insurance as well, health insurance as well. So you can apply to Kela after you come here, and then you can either be accepted or denied. Because I remember when I first applied to Kela, I was denied because I think during my application. So you have to fill it carefully, and then you get the feedback, or you get the decision. They call it a decision because I don't know. So if you were granted or not, so those things are super important to know. So just do not worry, have your 1 year certificate, come here, and then you can try to apply for Kela. So then when you are renewing your residence permit, you do not need to have another insurance certificate as far as you have your Kela card. It's called the Kela card. And just so you know, you have to be here in Finland to apply for Kela card, or actually have your residence permit in Finland to apply for a Kela card. You can apply outside Finland or from your home country. You have to be in Finland. So that's the little tip that I have for you guys, and I hope I've been of help today and I've answered some of your questions that you've been asking me all this while. And I wish you all good luck in your application, and be sure to subscribe, be sure to give this video a thumbs up, and be sure to subscribe, be sure to put on your post notifications so you are notified whenever I post a new video, and see you in my next video. Bye.